Good evening. Welcome to Frederick P. Rose Hall, the home of jazz at Lincoln Center, and the House of Swing. Tonight, you will be listening to music from the King of Swing, Mr. Benny Goodman. Your musical director for the evening is Mr. Victor Goines. Many of you know him from his many years with the orchestra. And we have a lot of music to get to tonight, and not a second to waste. Let's get it on. Please welcome to the Rose Theater stage, the Jazz and Lincoln Center Orchestra with Wynton Marsalis. Thank you.
Thank you. Welcome to the House of Swing. It's a pleasure to present the celebration of the 80th anniversary of Benny Goodman's historic Carnegie Hall concert. Our opening selection was entitled Don't Be That Way. It was composed by Edgar Sampson and was also the opening selection for Benny Goodman and his orchestra on that evening. Please give your appreciation for Walter Blandon on the tenor saxophone. Wynton Marsalis on the trumpet. Chris Crenshaw on the trombone. Now, while this concert was historic for a lot of reasons, the most significant was not because it was a jazz concert at Carnegie Hall. In fact, it was not the first jazz concert to be presented at Carnegie Hall. The concert was historic because of the manner in which Benny Goodman presented it to the audience that evening. He seized the opportunity to present four topics that were important to him. One was his ethnicity. Two, his musical influences. Three, the topic of racism and segregation in America. And four, his virtuosic abilities. So as Billy mentioned backstage, we have a lot of music for you tonight. So we're not gonna do a lot of talking. We're gonna move forward with it. The next two selections, Sometimes I'm Happy by Irvin Caesar and Vincent Yeoman, and I Got Rhythm by George and Ira Gershwin, will be performed by a young lady who comes to us from Ann Arbor, Michigan. I first heard her performing in Disney's Club Coca-Cola with the big band Diva. So we'd like you to please give her a warm round of applause as she comes to the stage. Ms. Janelle Reichman. Janelle Reichman.
Thank you.
Janelle Reichman on the clarinet. Dan Block on the tenor saxophone. Thank you very much. Joining us on I Got Rhythm will be a young man who is a graduate of the Juilliard Jazz Studies program. Please welcome on the vibraphone, Mr. Joseph Doubleday. Joseph Doubleday. Thank you. Janelle Reichman on the clarinet. Janelle Reichman. Joseph Doubleday on the vibe. Dan Nimmer at the piano. Marion Felder on the drums. Janelle Reichman on the clarinet. Thank you very much. We're going to stay in the George and Ira Gershwin songbook. The Man I Love was recorded in the summer of 1937 while the quartet was in Hollywood filming the musical Hollywood Hotel as a tribute to George Gershwin shortly after his death. To perform this piece will be a gentleman who comes to us by way of Los Angeles. He resides in New York. He's an alum of the Goodman Orchestra and has been a member of the Jazz at Lincoln Center Orchestra for 20 years. Please welcome Ted Nash. This is entitled The Man I Love.
Thank you.
clarinet. Ted Nash. Dan Nimmer at the piano. Joseph Doubleday on the vibe. Thank you very much. As a clarinetist, Benny Goodman's goal was to be the best and to perform with the best, regardless of race or creed. And the music he selected and performed reflected just that. One of the special guests on the 1938 concert was Count Basie. And the first of these next two selections, 1 o'clock Jump, is composed by the great Count Basie. The second selection, China Bar, was a favorite jam selection during the 1920s and 30s. Our next guest comes to us by way of Israel and now resides in New York. She's comfortable in various styles and genres of music. Please welcome to the bandstand on the clarinet, Miss Anat Cohen. Anat Cohen on the clarinet. Dan Nimmer at the piano. Walter Blandin on the tenor saxophone. Elliot Mason on the trombone. Kenny Rampton on the trumpet. This is China Boy. Thank you. Anat Cohen on the clarinet. Anat Cohen. Dan Nimmer on the piano. Marion Felder on the drums. Miss Anat Cohen. Thank you very much. Now, part of the program on the concert was a short survey entitled 20 Years of Jazz. In Goodman's words, 20 Years of Jazz was a salute to Dixieland jazz, then the legendary Big Spiderback, Ted Lewis, and Louis Armstrong, then Duke Ellington. The next two selections will be from that survey. The first, I'm Coming Virginia, was composed by Donald Haywood. That will be followed by Sensation Rag, a piece that Goodman performed to acknowledge one of his biggest influences, the original Dixieland Jazz Band. This is I'm Coming Virginia. On the trumpet, Kenny Rampton. On the clarinet, Walter Bland. This is Sensation Rag. Thank you. Reichman on the clarinet. Wynton Marsalis on the trumpet. Chris Crenshaw on the trombone. Dan Nimmer at the piano. Carlos Enriquez on the bass. Goodman alum, James Chirillo on the guitar. Thank you very much. Loch Lomond is a Scottish folk song that was a sensational hit in early 1938. For the Goodman Orchestra, it was a reworking of Claude Thornhill's 1937 arrangement for small group. This arrangement was prepared for the full orchestra by Jimmy Mundy. To assist us in this performance, please welcome to the stage a wonderful young vocalist who is based in New York. She first appeared at Jazz at Lincoln Center at the age of 11 when she performed at the Women in Jazz series at Disney's Club Coca-Cola. Please welcome Miss Veronica Swift. Thank you very much. Here are the final two selections of our first half. The first selection, Avalon, was from the small group portion of the program in a very popular selection for the quartet. And the final selection of this half, Blue Skies, was Goodman's tribute to the great Duke Ellington. It was arranged by Fletcher Henderson. Please welcome back on the vibes, Mr. Joseph Doubleday.
Thank you.
on the tenor saxophone. Wynton Marsalis on the trumpet. Thank you very much for coming out. We're going to take a pause for the cause. We are the Jazz at Lincoln Center Orchestra. We'll be right back.
A tisket, a tasket, a brown and yellow basket. I sent a letter to my mommy on the way.
People ask the stupidest questions sometimes. Like when I did Leaves of Grass. Oh, you did Whitman because he was gay. No, I didn't do Whitman because he was gay. I did Whitman because he wrote some of the most important words in the American literature. Well, I mean, I didn't stop playing and then decide to come out as gay and then start playing again. You know, it's just when I was doing some benefit recordings for AIDS Services organization, produced a jazz album with a lot of famous people, and all of a sudden found myself in Newsweek and CNN and The Advocate and Downbeat and just talking about being a HIV positive gay jazz musician, and it was really super liberating. That's my parents have known since I was 19, but coming out in a very public way, I felt like, you know, maybe there are people out there who are in a similar situation, who are not out about whatever they are, and they're spending a lot of energy being in some kind of closet, and you pay a price. And so I figured if I'm gonna be myself as an artist, I have to be myself as a person, and that's just kind of the way it is. And now it's, of course, a non-issue, and I go out to the clubs with my partner, everybody knows him, and so there's been a lot of change in my lifetime. You know, maybe I had a tiny bit to do with it. So that's part of why I'm here, too. It's just not the music.
Jazz at Lincoln Center spreads the gift of jazz through performance, education, and advocacy. Every year, we present concerts in our New York City home and in cities around the world. We teach tens of thousands of students of all ages and stream over 200 free webcasts reaching 1 million audience members. We do this to promote an appreciation for jazz, the quintessential American art form.
Jazz is one of the most American of the arts that we've created here, and one of the most culturally relevant art forms we have in America. We have to have support for organizations and an art form that has depth and profundity, that has real connections to the continuity of our way of life and our nationality.
We bringing the music to kids, and they're enjoying it, and we're opening their eyes to some good things. And what Jazz for Young People does as well is we couple the music with a social issue, or not just issues, but just social happenings that may have happened in the past or that's happening now.
We want kids to understand three basic things. Jazz has elements that relate to their lives. Swing, being working together in a group. Improvisation, which is the individual voice. Each person has their own individual statement. And then the blues, which is, you know, facing tough times and facing adversity with elegance and persistent optimism.
Kids need these, they need artistic outlets. They need to see instruments. They need to see music being played. They need to hear and understand and know about jazz music. They should, everybody should, in my opinion. We need music in schools, and people at Jazz at Lincoln Center are trying to fill a void.
Education programs are at the heart of our efforts to advance an understanding and appreciation of jazz and its unique place in American culture. Through education, we address the universal need in all of us for community, communication, self-expression, and a global perspective.
Thank you on behalf of all of us at Jazz at Lincoln Center for your enduring commitment. We couldn't do what we do without you. Thank you very, very much.
James for a visit by some of Life magazine's photographers. Benny Goodman thought it was a pretty good example of what swing meant in 1938, even at Carnegie Hall. You heard on the tenor saxophone, Walter Blanding. At the piano, Dan Nimmer. And on the trumpet, Wynton Marsalis. Thank you very much. The next three compositions we're going to perform are When My Baby Smiles at Me, Blue Room, and Dizzy Spells. When My Baby Smiles at Me was Benny's tribute to clarinetist Ted Lewis, and it was part of the 20 Years of Jazz portion of the program. The second composition, Blue Room, is a classic swinging arrangement by Fletcher Henderson, and Dizzy Spells is an example of Benny's virtuosic abilities. To perform these selections is a gentleman who truly exemplifies the meaning of virtuoso. He's an alum of the Goodman Orchestra and resides in New York City. Please welcome to the bandstand, Mr. Ken Peplowski. Thank you. On the clarinet. Dan Nimmer on the piano. This is Blue Room. On the clarinet, Kenny Rampton on the trumpet, thank you very much. Now, welcome back to the bandstand on the vibe, Mr. Joseph Doubleday. This is entitled Dizzy Spells.
I know I'm not supposed to say anything, but I've prepared about 15 minutes of rip. No. I just want to thank Wynton and thank Victor on behalf of all the clarinetists, but in particular me, for inviting us here to perform with what truly is one of the greatest group of musicians you could ever play with, really. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. It's a real honor. That's the end of my remarks. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. After all that fire, we have to slow it down. The piece you're about to hear, Blue Reverie, was composed by the great Duke Ellington. And it is another salute by Benny Goodman to him. In an attempt to get the Ellington sound, Benny invited Johnny Hodges, Harry Carney, and Cootie Williams to join the band. This is our rendition of Blue Reverie, and we hope you enjoy. Going to feature some of Walter Blandon on the soprano saxophone.
Thank you.
Zella on the baritone saxophone. Sherman Irby on the alto saxophone. Vincent Gardner on the trombone. And Goodman alum, James Trillo at the guitar. Blue Reverie. Benny Goodman thought this next selection was one of the high spots in the program. It was what he and his band termed the killer dilla in those days. This is Swing Time in the Rockies, and it's composed by Jimmy Mundy. To perform this selection, please welcome back to the bandstand, Miss Anat Cohen. Thank you. Anat Cohen. Dan Block on the tenor saxophone. Marcus Pritchard on the trumpet. And Miss Anat Cohen on the clarinet. Swing Time in the Rockies. One of Benny Goodman's all-time favorite selections was Stompin' at the Savoy. It was one of the few selections he recorded in the 1930s with both the big band and the small band. And the small band arrangement featured the great Lionel Hampton. Please welcome back to the bandstand to perform this selection. On the clarinet, Miss Janelle Reichman, and on the vibes, Mr. Joseph Doubleday.
Thank you.
Dan Nimmer at the piano. Stomping at the Savoy. Thank you very much. This selection that's coming up was composed by Jacob Jacobs and Shalom Secunda for a 1933 Yiddish musical entitled I Would If I Could. After the show closed, the song was sold to Brooklyn music publisher Jay Kamen, who printed a few copies of the piece to sell. Unfortunately, no one showed any interest in it, and it lay forgotten until Guy Lombardo stumbled upon it. After Lombardo featured the selection on his radio broadcast, the publishers were besieged by other orchestra leaders looking for it. The publishers immediately added new lyrics by Sammy Kahn and Saul Chaplin, changed the Yiddish name to German, and the song became a hit. That song is entitled By Mere Bitch Duchesne. Please welcome to perform that selection on the vocals, Miss Veronica Swift, and on the clarinet, Miss Anat Cohen.
Thank you. I could say bella, bella, even say wunderbar. Each language only helps me tell you how grand you
Swift on the vocals. Anat Cohen on the clarinet. Anat Cohen. Thank you very much. The next selection needs very little introduction. It's composed by the great Johnny Green and it's entitled Body and Soul. It was recorded by Goodman at his first trio sessions in July of 1935 and quickly became a signature tune for the ensemble. To perform on this selection with me, please welcome back to the bandstand, Mr. Ken Peplowski.
Thank you.
Ken Peplowski. Ken Peplowski on the clarinet. Dan Nimmer at the piano. Marion Feld on the drums. We want to thank you all very much for joining us to celebrate Benny Goodman and his 1938 Carnegie Hall concert. It has been our pleasure to present it to you, but we have one final selection. Before we start that piece, please welcome back to the bandstand Miss Janelle Reichman on the clarinet, Miss Anat Cohen, and this is entitled Sing, Sing, Sing. Thank you. On the trumpet, Marion Feld on the drums, Dan Block, Sherman Irby, Paul Netzella, Elliot Mason, Vincent Gardner, Chris Crenshaw, Kenny Rampton, Ryan Kaiser, Wynton Marsalis, Carlos Enriquez, James Chirillo, Dan Nimmer, Joseph Doubleday, Miss Veronica Swift. Thank you all so much for coming out. We hope you enjoyed our celebration of Benny Goodman in his 1938 Carnegie Hall concert. My name is Victor Goines, and we are the Jazz at Lincoln Center Orchestra. Thank you very much. Have a good night. Take care.